Subtracting mixed numbers with unlike denominators. Let's try an example. 9 7/8 minus 3 5/6. Let's set this problem vertically. We line up the fractions and the whole numbers. This is called stacked form. As you can see, we have unlike denominators, so we need to find a common denominator to subtract. To find the common denominator, we need to find the least common multiple between 6 and 8. So the common denominator is 24. Let's rename the first mixed number. To get 24 in the denominator, we have to multiply 8 by a number. That number is 3. We also need to multiply the numerator by 3. So now we have 9 21/24. Let's do the same to the second mixed number. What do we multiply 6 by to get 24? 4. We also have to multiply the numerator by 4. So the new mixed number is 3 20/24. Now we can subtract the mixed numbers. First, we subtract the fractions. 21/24 minus 20/24 is 1/24. Next, we subtract the whole numbers. 9 minus 3 equals 6. So the answer is 6 1/24. Let's do another example. 6 3/5 minus 2 1/2. Let's turn it into stacked form. We find the common denominator by finding the least common multiple between 5 and 2. So the common denominator is 10. To get 10 in the denominator, we multiply 5 by 2. We also multiply the numerator by 2 to get 6 6/10. Now let's rename 2 1/2. To get 10 in the denominator, we multiply 2 by 5. We also multiply the numerator by 5 to get 2 5/10. Now we can subtract the mixed numbers. First, we subtract the fractions. We get 1/10. Next, we subtract the whole numbers. 6 minus 2 equals 4. So the final answer is 4 1/10. Let's do another example. 7 2/5 minus 2 3/4. Let's turn it into stacked form. First, we find the common denominator. The common denominator between 5 and 4 is 20. To get 20 in the denominator, we multiply 5 by 4. We also multiply the numerator by 4 to get 7 8/20. Now let's rename the second mixed number. To get 20 in the denominator, we multiply 4 by 5. We also multiply the numerator by 5 to get 2 15/20. We can't subtract 15/20 from 8/20. This is because 8/20 is less than 15/20. So we have to rename the first mixed number as a mixed number with a fraction greater than 1. But how can we do that? Instead of 7 8/20, we can write 6 + 1 + 8/20. And now, instead of 1, we can write 20/20. Now we add the whole number and the two fractions to get 6 28/20. This is a mixed number with a fraction greater than 1. So now we can subtract. First, we subtract the fractions. 28/20 minus 15/20 gives us 13/20. Next, we subtract the whole numbers. 6 minus 2 equals 4. So the final answer is 4 13/20. Let's do another example. 5 1/4 minus 2 5/6. Let's set this problem vertically. The common denominator between 4 and 6 is 12. Let's rename the first mixed number. To get 12 in the denominator, we multiply 4 times 3. We also have to multiply the numerator by 3 to get 5 3/12. Let's do the same for the second mixed number. To get 12 in the denominator, we multiply 6 times 2. We also have to multiply the numerator times 2. So we get 2 10/12. We can't subtract 10/12 from 3/12 because 3/12 is smaller than 10/12. So we have to rename the first mixed number as a mixed number with a fraction greater than 1. We can rewrite the mixed number as 4 plus 1 plus 3 twelfths. We can also rewrite the 1 as 12 over 12. Now we add the whole number plus the two fractions to get 4 and 15 over 12. As you can see, now we can subtract. First we subtract the fractions. We get 5 over 12. Next we subtract the whole numbers. 4 minus 2 equals 2. So the final answer is 2 and 5 twelfths. If you thought this video was helpful, please leave a like. For more videos like this, please subscribe.